That awkward moment when you realize you're alone in the world. Oh no, there is a couple of people awake. Good morning, Petrus Vivius with your St. Lucia experience. Beach walk, 8 February 2021. It was a beautiful sunrise. There's the estuary mouth going south, and then it's creating this little bay over here. Maybe Patrick Jolly can explain to us. I read up that once you've got a hard structure on your southern side, the ocean starts digging on the northern side of that hard structure. Now maybe this is just a little phenomenon because of the extra flow that came out of the estuary. Maybe it's a worthwhile phenomenon to keep an eye on, I don't know. But we're still in neap tide, we're going towards spring and things is going to change rapidly. Free Spirit getting ready for the launch. The 200 starting beautifully there. Just want to get my muffler off. It's a float. It's a bad sandbank in front of them. It's when it takes all the skills of a skipper to wait for that right moment for the bay to fill up with water and the gap to open up on the other side of the sandbank. Now that is Free Spirit counting this, Walter counting the sets there. I don't know how Walter works his personal intuition to find the rhythm of the ocean to get the gap. I call it counting the sets. Some of the surfers disagree with me. They say you can't count the sets. Well, Walter worked that one out fine. Like a highway right into the ocean. Again, like a pro, Walter. Petri Heil. It's a German magazine like the South African Tightlines. Eventually I got the name right. And the white Suzuki thing, it's the same as the black Suzuki. It's just a color preference. Gone a little bit skew, but Wiseman corrected. Pushing away from the sand with the motor still trimmed high. I needed a couple of big waves to come in to fill up the gully. There's an ugliness standing in front of him while he's on drifting and floating on the sandbank. Ground a little bit of sand over there. He's gone over that one. One more. And that's how you do it. Patience and skill. Happy hunting, guys. Robert E. Lee, the working boat. Mike needs a lot more skills than the other skippers. His boat is much heavier, older design, more robust, and he's only got 2 140s on there. It takes him a while to get on the plane, and then he rather don't run away from them, he rather faces them. Eish, that's brushing your teeth. Well done, Mike. Happy hunting. I think it's pretty much low tide now. And it looks good. Let's go and have a see. Sweep from this angle. And then I don't like what I see in the front. That's not nice. I just want to irritate one of the subscribers. I love this Canon SX530HS. It's a beautiful machine. To the guys that made it possible, a huge shout out. Thank you. We can see that the scouring is working, but the plug at the bottleneck has not been severed yet. Look at how shallow the Amphalosi outlet there into the estuary mouth is. On this low tide, which is not spring low yet, we can see how important the scouring effect is and how powerful it is. Mechanical intervention. Although the scouring effect is working, we need mechanical intervention. We need dredging. We need water cannons. We need the public to open their minds so the scientists has got room to maneuver to make the right decisions. They won't bring in stuff that is going to damage nature more than it's going to harm nature more than it's going to have a positive outcome. Guys, please don't object to mechanical intervention. You can see that it's needed. We need mechanical intervention. Look at all this gunk that needs to be taken out. Look how it's bubbling over there. I need a tripod. I definitely need a tripod. Oh, I must remember to take my monopod with. Let me just try and zoom over there and you guys can see how powerful the scouring effect is. And managed properly, it can be used to control the sediment that comes from the catchment areas. I think that the water that's trapped in the Amphalosi River and the sugarcane farms at the moment is a clear indication that the filter system doesn't work. I had the argument the other day with a gentleman on the beach. Meneer, ek is jammer, ek het my vererg vir jou, maar ek probeer verduidelik dat al die water altyd op een slag hier kom. En dat as ons daai gebied agter Honeymoon Bend bestuur as 'n filtrasiesisteem. If we use that area behind Honeymoon Bend as a filtration system, like they did in the 1968 management plan, we can manage the sediment that comes down with a slow flowing Amphalosi River. when we need the fresh water to balance the salinity of the lake system. When the Mfolozi comes down and this much flood, we need it to go to the ocean. We can't manage the sediment buildup. The floodplains wouldn't be able to manage it either. They were clogged up. That's why the British government decided to put farmers there. The natural process of soil erosion, and we learned this in standard 5, and I think it's now grade 7, is for the mountains to erode into the valleys so that the farmers can farm. Now, what happened here is people are complaining that it shouldn't happen. Yes, we agree it must happen, but we don't see the need why we should turn a pristine estuarine system into a crop farmland if we can manage it as a pristine estuarine system. I find it difficult if people don't understand that, if they don't understand the importance of a functioning estuary system. I know that you guys want the planet to be natural, but it can't. You already drive on highways, you already drive with internal combustion engine motor vehicles. We can't have the planet functioning naturally anymore. We have to assist nature to neutralize our human impact. We must neutralize our footprint. Stop worrying about the effect of global warming and start acting proactively. Fix the habitats that can reverse global warming in a 48-hour cycle. And phytoplankton can do that. And this is supposed to be the marine system where phytoplankton is produced. Why can't we understand that? What is so difficult? I missed it. Damn it. Sorry I missed the video of the squirrel crossing the road, but I found the Smurfs. Splendor is where you find it. A dung beetle gathering his home. Shitty job, but somebody's got to do it. Say let nature takes its course. It's great. This was what happened if we leave nature to go about its business. If we want that, we can create it, but then we have to mitigate the impact. Capish? Mitigating the impact, we're creating a water flow channel, mitigating the impact. I'm sure you guys can understand that. It can't be that difficult. I'm not talking to the supporters that understand our nature work. I'm talking to the guys that wants to be negative about human interference. Human interference, mitigating the impact. Human interference, mitigating the impact. Okay. Ask me, why don't I allow people on my group to have a different opinion? I think Einstein said something about it. If you do the same thing over and over, expecting different results, then you get the ID10 error. ID10T error, sorry. Guys, you can't let stupid have a voice. They might think they've got the right to freedom of speech, but they just make other people stupid as well. I can debate with intelligent people, but once a person starts getting stupid about it, I've got nothing more to say to him except that he's stupid. And we have to accept the facts that humans have got an impact on Earth. And if we don't mitigate that impact, Earth will not survive. It's basic conservation 101. My eyes is not too bad, eh? Look at this beautiful critter I found. Mitigating the impact, we're creating a water flow channel. Mitigating the impact. I'm sure you guys can understand that. It can't be that difficult. I'm not talking to the supporters that understand our nature work. I'm talking to the guys that wants to be negative about human interference. Human interference, mitigating the impact. Human interference, mitigating the impact. Okay. My eyes is not too bad, eh? Look at this beautiful critter I found. That's the video for today. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe and share. And those guys that's running ad blockers, please allow this channel, ads on this channel. Then I don't need to beg for food and airtime and diesel money. Then it can pay for itself. I agree that there's very annoying ads out there. If it's an annoying ad, one of those long ones that's talking about instant wealth, just press skip. Just press skip. Google will quickly learn that this channel don't like those ads. Bad if it's a short video and it's not too annoying. It will help if you support the advertiser. Watch the video, click on the link, buy the product. The advertisers also need the support. And yeah, that's all I've got to say for today. Thanks for watching.